Water evidence on the moon. It's not raining on the moon, but it does seem to be getting wetter and wetter. For decades, the prevailing view of the moon was that it was dry. Then, 2 years ago, a NASA probe crashed into a deep crater near the moon's south pole and confirmed large amounts of water ice within the shadows. Meanwhile, measurements by an orbiting Indian spacecraft suggested that a veneer of water generated by the bombardment of solar wind particles covered much of the moon's surface. Now, scientists analyzing tiny fragments of hardened lava from long ago lunar eruptions report that the fragments contain about as much water as similar magmas on Earth, meaning there is plenty of water inside the moon too. I have to admit, we were a little surprised, said a staff scientist in geochemistry at the Carnegie Institution of Washington and lead author of a paper published Thursday in the journal Science. The scientist's surprise comes despite the fact that he and several of his co-authors predicted 3 years ago that they would find that much water. Back then, they looked at tiny beads of volcanic glass. The beads were about the size of periods in printed text, in soil brought back by Apollo astronauts. The beads contained water, but not a lot of it, a maximum of 46 parts per million, or 0.0046% water. Their models suggested that 95% of the water originally in the hot magma escaped as it cooled. The scientist acknowledged that the extrapolation was less than ironclad. That's sticking your neck out pretty far, he said. The new work started when another member of the research team, Alberto E. Sau, a professor of geological sciences at Brown University, handed a vial of moon dirt to Thomas Weinreich, a Brown freshman, and asked him to sift through it for interesting particles. As Mr. Weinreich laboriously examined the soil, grain by grain, under a microscope, he found, mixed among the glass beads, some clear crystals. Some of those crystals contained a tiny amount of glass. The crystals, made of the mineral olivine, prevented any of the water in the enclosed glass from escaping. The amount of water in the trapped glass was 20 to 100 times what had been previously measured in the glass beads, comparable to the water content of some Earth magmas. There is a reservoir down there in the moon that has the same concentration of water as some reservoirs in the upper mantle of Earth, Dr. Sau said. That's for sure. What is much less certain is how large the underground water-rich reservoir might be. Last year, researchers led by Zachary D. Sharp of the University of New Mexico came to the exact opposite conclusion. Based on concentrations of chlorine isotopes in lunar rocks, they concluded that the rocks must have hardened out of lava that contained almost no water. But if the interior of the moon turns out to contain considerable water, then the ice at the bottom of lunar craters may have come from volcanic eruptions rather than comet impacts. The finding would also throw a new wrinkle into explanations of how the moon formed in the aftermath of a collision between the Earth and a Mars-sized interloper some 4.6 billion years ago. The cataclysm would have created a ring of debris at an intensely hot temperature in the thousands of degrees, and the expectation of many scientists is that any water would have escaped into space before the debris coalesced into a dry moon. It's frankly a confusing picture, said David J. Stevenson, a professor of planetary science at the California Institute of Technology. The giant impact theory provides a satisfying explanation for the orbit, size, and basic physical characteristics of the moon. But scientists have not been able to fully explain what makes up the moon, and the water finding potentially adds another mystery. What you will find among geochemists, cosmic chemists, there's still some doubt there, Dr. Stevenson said. They say, that's a wonderful story, but how does it fit my data? Nonetheless, finding water on the moon is an extraordinary discovery. Water has also been discovered on Mars, and water is life. There really is no life without water. In other words, life has already been found on other places besides the Earth, and water is the life and spirit of God, the creator of everything. Yes, life and water are a part of the same thing. This too is another sign of the times, the end times, transition day, which is a continuing day-by-day process of extraordinary changes, happenings, and events. Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. 3. And God said, Let there be light, and there was light. 4. And God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. 5. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day. 6. And God said, Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. 7. And God made the firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. 8. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. 9. And God said, Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. Revelation chapter 22, verse 12. And, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every human according as his work shall be. 13. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. It's time for all prophecy to be fulfilled. Everything is connected, and everything is numbered.